Good morning one and all. So today we will start our class. Now in the last class we have seen something called mean and variance. As I told you, they are very important parameters of any random variable. Okay, so we have seen some properties of mean and variances. So mean is nothing but expectation, or sometimes also called as average. Variance is always positive, always non-negative. So this is very, very important. So random variable y is a function of random variable x, y equal to ax plus b, and if it is so, the expectation of y equal to a into expectation of x plus b, variance of y equal to a square into variance of x, or a square into sigma square. What is sigma square? Is called variance. What is sigma? Is called standard deviation. The square root of the variance is called standard deviation. Now let us find out the mean and variances of our standard random variables. So in the previous classes we have discussed about a Bernoulli random variable. What is a Bernoulli random variable? So it's a random variable which has got only two outcomes. For example, if you toss a coin, you may get head or tail, only two possibilities. So suppose x is a Bernoulli random variable, if you get a head, we assign a number 1. If you get a tail, we assign a number 0. Now this is the random variable, and now it is defined. It need not be tossing a coin, it could be anything, any experiment that has got only two possibilities. As I told you in the last classes, it could be conducting an experiment where the possible outcomes are success or failure. Okay, now it's PMF. As I told you in the last classes, the PMF is P if x equal to 1, Q if x equal to 0. Now so we have to find the mean of this random variable x. First of all, what is the mean of x formula? Mean or expectation of x, summation over x, x into its PMF. Here, so small x is having only two values, either 0 or 1. Now what happens if x equal to 1 into what is the PMF? P plus. If x equal to 0 into what is the corresponding PMF? Q. So anyway, this is 0. Now we are left with only P. Now what is P? That is the mean of the Bernoulli random variable. Okay. Now, so next, what is the variance? Variance of x. First of all, how to find variance of x? The simplest formula would be expectation of x square minus expectation of x whole square. So this is nothing but mean, just now we have calculated, that is nothing but how much P. Now we have to calculate expectation of x square. So it is called second moment. What is the formula? Summation over x, x square into its PMF. Now here also x is 1 or 0. If x is 1, 1 square is 1 only, right? 1 into. If x equal to 1, what is the corresponding PMF? P plus. If x is 0, what x square? Again 0. 0 into what a PMF? Q. It is also P. Now what is the variance? P minus mean square. What is the mean? Again P. P minus P square. What is the variance? P minus P square. Okay. Now this is the second moment. Now finally, what is the variance? P minus P square, or P into 1 minus P. Now this is the mean and variance of a Bernoulli random variable. In the same way, we have to find out mean and variance of all other remaining random variables. Because random variable is defined with its mean and variance. They are the two important parameters of a random variable. Okay. Now we'll discuss one more kind of random variable, that is called discrete uniform random variable. What is it called? Discrete uniform random variable. Okay. How it is defined? The PMF of this discrete uniform random variable is 1 by b minus a plus 1 if k varies from a plus 1 so on b, 0 otherwise. Okay. Where a or b are integers, where b is more than a, b is greater than a. K varies from a to b, a and b are integers. Okay. What actual it is? Suppose you take this a to b, a and b are integers, for example 1 to 4, you take only integers. How many integers are there? 1 2 3 4. How many integers are there? Now what the length would be? Length would be how much? 4. So here just don't do 4 minus 1. 4 minus 1 will be 3 only. But here if you take all integers, there are 4 integers. That is called length. Okay. Now how to find out that length? Generally what we do? Upper limit is 4 minus lower limit is 1 plus 1. That equal to again 4. So this is how we calculate the length of the integers or discrete case. Okay. Same thing happens here. Here, what is the PMF? 1 by b minus a plus 1. Why b minus a plus 1? Because what is the length of integers between a and b? Upper integer is b minus lower integer is a plus 1. Now 1 by length. Okay. Now this is how it is defined. Now if you draw the PMF, how it would be? If you draw it, it would be something like this. You take a line, it can be krx, its PMF, px of k. K varies from where to where? A to b. This is a plus 1, so on, this is b. Okay? This is b. Now, how they are defined? Now, they are all uniform, always they are uniform, they are same. So all are uniformly distributed. What is the value of this? 1 by b minus a plus 1. Now this is called discrete uniform random variable. It is discrete and uniform because all are equal. Is it okay? At each and every integer, so the PMF is uniform. This is B. The last one is B. So it is defined from A to B. Okay. For example, if it is defined from 1 to 10, let us take 1 to 10. Okay. It is defined from 1 to 10. What will you do? This is 1, this is 10. So what would happen? The random variable is defined like 1, 2, 3, 4, so on up to 10. Now, what if this value would be? All are same. Value would be how much? You compare these two. Here, A equal to 1. B equal to 10. So, what about these random variables? I mean, PMFs? 10 minus 1 plus 1. That equal to 10. This would be 1 by 10. So this is the discrete uniform random variable. Uniform because it is same for each and every integer. And how much is the probability? 1 over length. This is called length. 1 over length or 1 by length. Yeah, so there is one more way of defining is, suppose it is from k equal to 1 to n, it is simply 1 by n, 0 otherwise. Just now I told you, suppose if n equal to 10, means 1 to 10, this would be 1 by 10. 1 by 10 if k equal to 1 to 10, 0 otherwise. Now, I told you one property of PMF. What is that? Sum of all PMF should be 1. If you add all these PMFs, you get 1. Why? Because generally what happens? You take this PMF, this case. Okay. So it is 1 by 10. It is same for all integers. 1 by 10 plus plus on 1 by 10. How many times you are adding? 10 times. So it would be equal to 1 definitely. Okay. Now it satisfies the sum of all PMF should be equal to 1 concept. Now in the same way, let us take an example. What is the mean and variance of a roll of a fair six-sided die? Okay. We are rolling a six-sided die which is fair. And what is the mean and variance of a fair of a roll of a fair of a six-sided die? Now, so we should model, how should we model? Okay, let us go with the example. Okay, solution. Now, so x is the outcome, x equal to roll of a random variable, otherwise x equal to roll of a random variable, outcome of a random variable, x roll of a die, 6 space die. Okay. Now, so since it is a fair die, so probability of getting 1 is same as probability of getting 2. So on, same as probability of getting 6. All are equal, that would be equal to 1 by 6. Now, so now x can be a random variable, that is nothing but outcome of a roll of a die. X could be what? X could be 1 to 6. Or we can say that small x is equal to 1 to 6. Because what is small x? Any possible value of capital X. Now, how to find PMF? What is the definition of PMF? P x of small x equal to x or k. Anything is okay. Probability that capital X equal to small x. Now if I ask you, what is P x of 1? Probability that capital X equal to 1. Now what is capital X? Roll of a die. Now which means it says that what is the probability that roll of a die equal to 1? How much probability? All are equal, that is 1 over 6. Now in the same way, what would be the P x of 2? Which means probability that x equal to 2, which means probability that the roll of a die is 2, that is also 1 over 6. Now if you write everything in the form of equation, so the PMF would be Px of x equal to, it is always 1 over 6 if x varies is from 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 0 otherwise. Now, what kind of random variable is this? Uniform. You just go back and check. I told you. Now, so it is exactly a uniform random variable. Just now we have discussed. So this kind of thing. Okay. Here n equal to 6, that's it. 1 over 6, if k varies from 1 to 6, 0 otherwise. As I told you, I can use k or x, both. I can use them interchangeably. Okay. Now it is uniform discrete random variable. Now the question is, we have to find mean and variance. Okay, now to find mean, first of all I should know PMF. So I got the PMF. Now what the formula? Summation over x, x into its PMF, px of x. Now, so anyway, here x varies from where to where? X equal to 1 to 6, isn't it? It varies from 1 to 6. Now, so x into px of x. Now this PMF is always same, 1 by 6. Okay, so when x varies from 1 to 2, the PMF is always 1 by 6, which is a constant, which is uniform. You can take outside the summation. Now further you can write, this is 1 over 6 summation x equal to 1 to 6 x. Now here this equal to 1 over 6 into 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus 4 plus 5 plus 6. How much is this? 3, 3, 6, 10, 15. So 21 by 6. Or 7 by 2. Or equal to 3.5. So please check with the calculations. I am not sure about calculations. You check this. Okay. Now we are done with the mean. Mean is 3.5. Now what about variance? Now we know variance of x equal to expectation of x square, expectation of x square minus mu square. I am writing directly mu square. So just now we got mu. How much? 3.5. So we need to know the second moment. Now what is expectation of x square? Now that simply says x square into px of x over x. Now again px of x is 1 by 6. Take outside the summation. Summation over x, x square. X varies from where to where? 1 to 6. Now just like adding the sum of squares. 1 by 6 into 1 square plus 2 square plus 3 square plus 4 square plus 5 square plus 6 square. You calculate this. Okay. So the variance you get is, I'm writing directly, it is 35 by 12. You calculate this, and after that, what is that? So subtract from this, subtract mu square. You get 35 by 12. Now that is the mean and variance of the given. Yeah. So the above random variable is a special case of a discrete uniform random variable. Yeah. So next, the mean and variance of a discrete uniform random variable. Now this is a mean and variance of a discrete uniform random variable. So I'm not doing all the calculations. If time permits, I'll do later. So expectation of x or mean. Mean equal to a plus b by 2. Variance equal to b minus a into b minus a plus 2 by 12. Or otherwise, if I write something like this, if I write px of x equal to 1 over n, where k varies from 1 to n, 0 otherwise. See, both are valid PMFs. Okay. Now then what do you write? Expectation of x equal to n plus 1 by 2 and variance equal to n square minus 1 by 12. Now, so in the previous example, what was n? N was 6. Do you remember? The n was 6. This value was 6. Now, What is the expectation of x would be? 6 plus 1 by 2, 7 by 2, it should be 7 by 2. Variance, 6 square minus 1 by 2, 6 square means 36 minus 1, 35 by 12. Okay, if you know these formulas, you can write directly. Okay, so both are valid, this and this. Now, when this is valid, you see, remember, here k varies from 1 to n, but it is not always guaranteed that k varies from 1 to n. It can go from 2 to 10 also. Maybe 3 to 10, something like that. So, in that situations, we go with a and b. If it varies from 2 to 10, a equal to 2, b equal to 10. So, if it is varies from 3 to 10, a equal to 3, b equal to 10. So, in that situations, we go with this a and b concept. If it is varies from 1 to some number, this is very simplest one. N plus 1 by 2, this is n square minus 1 by 2. Otherwise, this is also correct. Okay. So, you substitute a equal to 1 and b equal to 6. In this example, substitute a equal to 1, b equal to 6. What happens? 1 plus 6 by 2. Again, 3.5. You substitute b equal to 6, a equal to 1, 6 minus 1, 5 into, so b minus a plus 2, 7 by 12, that is also equal to 35 by 12. So both are correct, but so if it is given from 1 to n, you go with this. If it is starts from other than 1, you go with this. Okay. Now, so let us find the mean and variance of a Poisson random variable. Okay. Now, I told you, so the Poisson random variable, the important parameter is lambda. If you remember, okay. Now let me write its PMF. So we have written XRK. I don't remember. Anything is okay, right? So e power minus lambda into, let me write K. So px of k that equal to e power minus lambda lambda power k by k factorial. So this is the k varies from 0 to infinity. Correct? This is the PMF of the given Poisson random variable. This is a PMF. Now we are asking mean and variance of this random variable. First of all, let me write the mean formula. So I'm writing directly. Please pay your attention. K varies from 0 to infinity. Because K varies from 0 to infinity, K into its PMF. What is the PMF of that? E power minus lambda, lambda power K by K factorial. This is what the expectation of that Poisson random variable. But here, if k equal to 0, what is the answer? What happens? If k equal to 0, everything is 0. Because it is k into something. Now, k cannot be 0. So, it is non-zero from where to where? K equal to 1 to infinity, k into e power minus lambda into lambda power k by k factor. Correct? Now this is the mean of the Poisson random variable. But here we have to find out its value. It is an infinite summation. We have to find out its value. Now, so let us take Taylor series expansion. Do you remember Taylor series? Now, that is e power x equal to 1 plus x by 1 factorial plus x square by 2 factorial plus so on so on. Now, in our case, we don't have e power x. We have what? E power lambda. So, let me write e power lambda. Lambda is a parameter. 1 plus x plus, sorry, 1 plus lambda plus lambda square by 2 factorial plus so on so on. It continues. It is infinite summation, infinite sum. Now, so I will do differentiation on both sides with respect to what? With respect to lambda. What do I get? Now, before that, so can you write this in the form of summation? Before differentiating, let me write in the form of summation. What can I write? K equal to 0 to infinity. What is that? That is lambda power k by k factor. Do you accept this? So I am writing this as this part, right hand side, like this. So what is this? Lambda power k by k factorial. K varies from 0 to infinity. Sum of all values where k varies from 0 to infinity, lambda power k by k factorial. Okay, now do differentiation. Now what do you get? So to the left hand side, if I differentiate e power lambda, again I will get same thing. What about right hand side? Summation is as it is. What do you get? So k factorial, that is constant. We don't do differentiation. Now differentiate lambda power k with respect to lambda. What do you get? K into lambda power k minus 1. Okay, now so remember this please. Okay, so what I got is e power lambda equal to summation k equal to 0 to infinity k factorial k into lambda power k minus 1. This is what I got after differentiation. Now so what I write here is e power lambda equal to summation k varies from 0 to infinity k by k factorial into lambda power k by lambda. Do you accept this? I am writing lambda power k minus 1 as lambda power k by lambda. Now what I do here is e power lambda equal to, I will write 1 by lambda outside the summation because we are summing with respect to k. So 1 by lambda would be something like constant. Now this is nothing but k equal to 0 to infinity k by k factorial. Is it okay? Now again, if k equal to 0, this would be 0. So it is non-zero from where to where? From where to where? 1 to infinity. So let me write e power lambda equal to 1 by lambda summation k equal to 1 to infinity k by k factorial. Okay, now what I do here is I'll take e power lambda this side, lambda this side. Now what happens here is lambda comes this side, e power minus lambda summation k equal to 1 to infinity k by k factorial. Now since e power lambda is independent of k, I can take inside a summation also. Now lambda would be equal to e power minus lambda, sorry, I am taking that inside a summation. Now this would be equal to k equal to 1 to infinity e power minus lambda into k by k factorial. Sorry, I'm missing something. Yeah, here I forgot to write k by k factorial into lambda power k. I'm sorry. Now what is this? Now if you write in the standard form, Now lambda equal to summation k equal to 1 to infinity e power minus lambda into lambda power k by k factorial into k. This is what I have. Is it not? Now, so I have written same thing here. Both are same. Now, what is this? Can you tell me? You go back. What is this? This is a mean. K equal to 1 to infinity e power minus lambda lambda per k by k factorial into k. Same thing is here. Exactly same thing. It is also mean. Now what is the expectation of x now? Mean. What is that? Lambda. Okay. Now, so I am not doing variance because you do one more thing. So take one more time differentiation. You find out the variance. One more time differentiation and you find out the variance. I'll give you the answer. You get expectation of x square as lambda square plus lambda. Now what is the variance? What is the variance? Lambda square plus lambda, expectation of x square minus mean square minus lambda square. Minus lambda square. Finally, what happens to the variance? It is also equal to lambda. Now, the mean and variance of a Poisson random variable is lambda. Now, that's why I told you in the last class itself, both are lambda. Lambda, lambda. Mean and variance both are same, both are equal to lambda. So we discuss a problem. So I don't remember the problem number. So we discuss one problem for the Poisson distribution. In the problem, I have mentioned that, yeah. So average. Average number, average means nothing but mean generally. So that's why I have taken mean that equal to lambda that equal to how much? 2. Okay, so in the problem itself they given average means they gave you the mean, which means lambda equal to 2. So by taking lambda equal to 2, we would solve the problem. Okay, now please remember for this Poisson distribution or Poisson random variable, so the mean and variance both are same, they are equal to lambda. Okay. Now so let us take one more problem. So before that, read the problem properly. So there is a quiz game. Okay, what they are saying is, you will be given two questions. Which question to answer first? You can decide which question to answer first. You have a freedom to decide which question to be answered first. Question A will be answered correctly. There are two questions, A and B. Question A will be answered correctly with a probability 0.8. So answered wrongly means what the probability? Obviously that is 0.2. Correctly 0.8, wrongly 0.2. That is for question A. So let us write. So probability of answering question A correctly is 0.8. Obviously, probability of answering question A wrong is 0.2. Now, this is about question A. What about question B? Now, one more thing. And the person will receive a prize of 1000 rupees. So if you answer question A correctly, you will get 1000 rupees. While question B will be answered correctly with the probability 0.5. So obviously, what about now you get amount? How much amount you get? 1000 rupees. Now question B answered correctly with the probability 0.5. It is 50-50 chance. Obviously, so probability that you answer wrongly, B complement is 0.5. Correct? Now you get and the person will receive a prize of 2000. For if you answer the question B correctly, you will get how much money? 2000, double money. So this is a scenario. But so there is a condition. What is that condition? Let us read the condition. So you will be given two questions, question A, question B, and there are some probabilities of answering correctly and wrongly, and you get some amount of money if you answer them correctly. But here is the trick. If the first question attempted is answered incorrectly, the quiz terminates, which means if you answer the first question wrongly, the quiz will be terminated. Okay? I.e., the person is not allowed to attempt the second question. If the person if the first question is answered correctly, the person is allowed to attempt the second question. Now, which question should be answered first to maximize the expected value of the total prize money received? So this is simple logic. So simply, there are two questions to be answered and they have corresponding probabilities of answering correctly, incorrectly, and you get some money if you answer them correctly. But the trick is, so if you answer the first question wrongly, you will be out of the competition. Suppose if you answered the first question correctly and you are allowed to attempt the second question. Okay. Now in this situation, so which question should be answered first so that you get maximum money? The logic is you have to find out which question should be answered first so that you get maximum money. Okay. Now generally, so our aim is to earn more money. Now let us call that as a random variable. Random variable is a total money that you get. X is a random variable that you get money. X is a random variable, so that is nothing but money n. Now, so we have to find out the mean of this random variable. Now, so what will you do simply? Okay, suppose if you answer the question B first, what may happen? You may get 2000. If it is correct, you get 2000. If it is wrong, why? Because so the question B has 50-50 chances. It has got more prize money, at the same time it has got 50-50 chance. So there is only 50% probability that you will answer correctly and 50% probability that you answer wrongly. So it's a risk. It includes risk. Okay. So let us take both cases. What will happen? Okay. Now, so this is the scenario 0.8, 0.2, 1000, 2000 random variable. So let me take a simple question. Case 1. Otherwise, question A is answered first. If I answer question A first, what are the situations? What are the possibilities? What may happen? I am attempting the question A. Okay. Now, what may happen is, I may answer wrongly. What is the probability? 0.2. You may answer wrongly. If you answer the first question itself wrong, how much money you get? You get 0. You don't get anything. If you answer the first question wrongly, you don't get any money. You will be out of the game. Okay? How much money you get? 0. If you answer the question A correctly, which means you answered first question correctly with the probability 0.8. Now, then what may happen? Again, in the question itself, they have told us that. So, if you answer the first question correctly, you are allowed to attempt the second question. Now, so you will be answering second question, means question B. Again, there are two possibilities. What are they? So, you may answer second question wrongly with the probability 0.5. So, how much money you get here? So, you start from here. So, if you give wrong answer to the question A, you will get zero money. The probability of giving wrong answer is 0.2. Now, if you give correct answer 0.8, at this point, you will be answering second question. Now, if second question, this is the first question, or question A, this is question B. Now, again, two things may happen. Question B, you may give wrong answer, you may give correct answer. Both are equiprobable, that is 0.5. Now, the question is, so how much money you get here? Here, what happened? You answered first question correctly, second question wrongly. With the probability, with the money, how much money you get? 1000. Because you answered only first question correctly. That is question A. You answered question B wrongly. Now here, you answered both correctly. Question A, question B. Which means, for question A, 1000 rupees. Question B, 2000. Total, 3000. Now, here. So, this is called sequential description. This is called sequential description. Now, here random variable x. X is the money earned. So, random variable x can be three values. What are they? How much money you get? That is random variable. Now, x can be, capital X can be zero money. It can be 1000. It can be 3000. So, what is the probability that you get zero money? Px of 0, I am writing PMF. It means probability that x equal to 0. What is capital X? Money earned, money gained. What is the probability that you get 0 money? So that is Px of 0. How much is the probability? 0.2. That equal to 0.2. Now, next, what is the probability that you get 1000 rupees? Now, when you get 1000 rupees, in this scenario, the question A is answered correctly and question B is answered wrongly. Now, how to get probability? You multiply these two, 0.8 into 0.5. You multiply these two, 0.8 into 0.5. This is 0.8 into 0.5. Now, what is the probability that you get 2000 rupees? That is again same, 0.8 into 0.5. You multiply these two. Okay. Now, finally, so this is a PMF we have. Okay. Now, I am asking expectation of X. Now, what is that? Sum over X, X into PX of X. Now we have three values for x. What are they? 0, 1000, 3000. Now here, if x is 0, 0 into px of 0. So that is anyway 0. 0 into px of 0 plus next 1000 into px of 1000, 1 came writing, plus 3000 into px of 3k. Now, if you do so, anyway, this is 0, 1000 into 0.8 into 0.5, plus 3000 into 0.8 into 0.5. You calculate and tell me how much is the answer. So I hope it is 1600. Please do your calculations. Now that is, now this is case one where we answered question A first. Now let us take another case. Question B answered first. Now what may happen? Question B. You are answering question B first. You may get, you may wrong answerly with the probability 0.5, correctly 0.5. So if you wrong answerly, you get zero money. Isn't it? Now, so at this point, again, so since you answered first question correctly, you are allowed to attempt another question. So please make a note of this. Here we are answering B question. Here we answer A question. Now if that is so, now what is the probability that you answer question A properly, I mean correctly? That is 0.8. This is 0.2. Now here how much money you get? You answered B correctly, A wrongly, which means 2000. Here you answered both correctly, you get 3000. Am I correct? You check it once, please. Now, so if you look at the probabilities also, now here random variable x, again it can be 0, 2000 and 3000. Here random variable takes on x is nothing but money earned, you know, 0 amount, 2000 and 0 amount, 2000 and 3000. So I am writing directly. So what a probability of px of 0, getting 0 money, what a probability of getting 0 money? What is that? 0.5. Here is 0.5. So px of getting money 2000. How much? What a probability? You multiply these two. So 0.5 into 0.2. That is 0.1. Okay, next. So what the probability of getting 3000? What the probability? 0.5 into 0.8. Multiply these two. 0.5 into 0.8. Now what is the expectation of this random variable? So I am not writing this 0 because anyway it is 0. Now it is 2000 into 0.5 into 0.2 plus 3000 into 0.5 into 0.8. Now what do you do? You do calculation, tell me the answer. Now it is, how much is this? Oh, let me do calculations. It is around 1400. Now this is B answered firstly. Expectation of x equal to 1600 if you answer A first. Now it is, now what is the best scenario would be? It is preferred to answer question A first because you have more chance of getting more money compared to the answering question B. Now, we can also visualize like this. So here, since question B is having more prize money and question A is having less prize money, generally people think that I will attempt this question B because it has got more prize money. But if you take average, an average, so if you answer question A first, you get, there's a probability that you get more money. Okay. Now, so this is a table which is very, very important. So I have written all random variables starting from Bernoulli. So this is Bernoulli random variable and its PMF and mean and variance. Binomial, its PMF, mean and variance. Geometric, its PMF, mean and variance. Poisson, its PMF, mean and variance. Discrete uniform, its PMF, mean and variance. Okay, so this table includes all 5 discrete random variables along with their PMFs and their means and their variances. So this table is very, very, very important. Okay, so if time permits, I will prove all these means and variances. We have proved Poisson and Bernoulli. We have proved only 2. Okay, so if time permits, I will prove all remaining 3 also. Okay. But so you must know the means and variances of all these 5 random variables. They are of discrete type. So in the next unit, we'll discuss continuous random variables. Okay, these are all discrete random variables. Now, so today I'll briefly start joint PMFs of a multiple random variables. So till now we are dealing with only a single random variable x, but there could be more than one number of random variables. There could be a multiple random variables. Now, so if there are multiple number of random variables, then the corresponding PMF is called joint PMF. Okay, suppose there are 2 discrete random variables x and y. Now, what a joint PMF is defined? First of all, how is PMF defined? If there is only one random variable, Px of x equal to probability that capital X equal to X. If there are 2 random variables, what do you write? P of xy, probability that X equal to small x, y equal to small y. Now, this is how we define. Okay, what do you write here? X type write capital Y equal to small y. What do you mean by this? The meaning is something like this. The meaning is, what do you mean by that? The meaning is something like this. So if I say probability that x equal to small x and capital Y equal to small y, which means probability that x equal to small x and y equal to small y. That is a precise meaning of this notation. Or you can simply write intersection. So this is the more than one random variable or multiple random variable. In this examples, I have taken 2 random variables x comma y. Okay. Now, so this is very, very important. Marginal PMFs from joint PMFs. What a joint PMF? This PMF of more than one random variable is called joint PMF generally. Now, here, so we should find marginal PMFs from where? From joint PMFs. Now I know Px comma y of x comma y. From that I should get Px of x. How it is done? Taking summation over y. Okay, please remember that. So please remember like this. I have joint PMF Px comma y of x comma y. I have. From that, I want Px of x. How it can be done? By taking summation over what? Y. Okay. Now, suppose from this, if I want Py of y, what will you do? Reverse. Reverse means we take summation over x. That is precisely I have written below. So you just remember like this. So if you want y to be eliminated, you take summation over y. So if you want x to be eliminated, you take summation over x. That's it. Okay. So if you want some variable to be eliminated, take summation over that variable. Okay, as simple as that. So you must know how to find out these two. So from joint PMF, you would find out marginal PMF of x, at the same time PMF of y. So this is very, very important. Okay, so just remember like this. So if you want y to be eliminated, take summation over y. So if you want x to be eliminated, take summation over x. As simple as that. Okay. Now here, so we have a method. So that is called tabular method. So tabular method two for calculating marginal PMFs from joint PMFs. Okay. So it is a two-dimensional table. So this x, y, this small x, small y. Now each square in this table represents a joint PMF. Okay. Suppose if I ask you what is px, y of 2, 3, which means small x equal to 2, small y equal to 3. Small x equal to 2, okay, and small y equal to 3. This is the corresponding square box. Now what is that? 2 by 20. In this way, each and every square represents a joint PMF. Like this, we have how many? 16 joint PMFs. Okay. Now from the joint PMFs, we have to find out marginal PMFs. What do you find out? We have to find out marginal PMFs. Now how we do? Okay, let me go back here. Now, so to calculate px of x, we add the numbers in the column corresponding to x. Okay, next, to calculate py of y, we add numbers in a row corresponding to y. So in this tabular method, to calculate PMF, we add rows or columns. Why it is so? Okay, so let me go back to the table itself. First of all, if I want px of x, let me go to the formula directly. So here, to get px of x, what we have done here? To get px of x, we are taking summation over y. We are keeping x constant, we are taking summation over y. Okay. Means here x is constant. Suppose x equal to 1. Y varies from where to where? 1 to 4. You add all the numbers in the column. You add all the numbers in the column. So now 0 plus 1 by 20 plus 1 by 20 plus 1 by 20, that is 3 by 20. Now what is this? Px of 1. Now if you want Px of 2, you want Px of 2. Here what is small x? 2. Now this is a 2. Now you add all the numbers in the column corresponding to x equal to 2. Add all the numbers in the column corresponding to x equal to 2. Now add elements 1 by 20 plus 2 by 20 plus 2 by 20 plus 1 by 20. How much? 6 by 20. If you want px of 3, which means x equal to small x equal to 3, you take this. Now add all the elements in the column corresponding to the x equal to 3. 1 by 20, 3 by 20, 3 by 20, 1 by 20. How much you get? 8 by 20. In the same way, this is px of 4. Now to find out px of x, we add columns. What we do? We are adding what? Columns. Column sum. To find out marginal PMF of x, we are adding the columns. Now to find out PMF of y, obviously you add rows. Suppose if you want py of 1, which means small y equal to 1. Now add corresponding row, elements in the row. Add numbers in a row corresponding to y equal to 1. What are they? 1 by 20, 1 by 20, 1 by 20, 0. That is 3 by 20. This is py of 1. What is py of 2? Take the y equal to 2. Add all the numbers in the corresponding row. Same thing for y equal to 3 and y equal to 4. So simply to find out marginal PMFs, we are adding numbers in the columns and rows. That's it. Adding the table entries along corresponding column or row. Okay. So to find out PMF of x, what do you add? Columns. To find out PMF of y, what do you add? You add rows. Okay. So this is one of the simplest ways of finding the marginal PMF from joint PMFs in the tabular method. Just adding the entries in the rows and columns. Okay. Anyway, so we stop here. Thank you.